Since you guys enjoyed the little moving Christmas figurine in the background of yesterday's video, I'm shooting this from a different location in my house with two figurines of moving creepy things in the background. Especially this guy over here. This one freaks the hell out of Girl Fiend. She says it sucks her soul out when she sleeps. Is that right, Girl Fiend?
I refuse to be in that room.
All right. Anyways, Girl Fiend won't be in this video because she refuses to be in the living room. Anyway, it's weird what you'll find just, you know, walking around. And I found something today that got my rant gears going, for lack of a better term. And it's a concept, a fallacy, or whatever you want to call it. And I found it in a bumper sticker of all things. A bumper sticker that is a patriotic way of promoting what I feel is a form of censorship now. This, of course, is my opinion of it, and you may feel different and all that other good shit. Now, I gotta tell you, before I show you this bumper sticker, which I'll show you very soon here, it's kind of a touchy situation because it's covering a bumper sticker that talks about the U.S. military. Now, I'm not going to sit here for minutes on end telling you, you know, how much I'm for the American military or that I'm qualified to give an opinion about the American military or anything like that, because I shouldn't have to. I'm just giving you an opinion, and as the old saying goes, I may not like what you have to say, but I will defend your right to say it. And that is something I've always believed in. Even if I block some assholes that give me death threats, I still, you know, let them say their piece, leave their comments on my videos, and just shit like that. But then they're the first people to go crying to their masters saying, "Oh, the Archfiend blocks me because I gave him a death threat." But then he criticized someone else for blocking people. Anyways, yeah, idiot AVGen fanboy. Sorry. Don't mean to get on that topic again. Anyway, that is an example, just to backtrack for a second, of me blocking someone who gives a death threat towards me. That is someone who is physically trying to cause me harm, or want to, or just send out the message that people should cause me harm. I should be killed, murdered, bludgeoned, punched in the face, whatever, for my opinion. Does someone like that, should they have the right to just come on my channel and keep spewing death threats? No. They should be quote-unquote censored by someone like me. That is an example of what I feel is a necessary censorship, for lack of a better term. Now, this bumper sticker that I'm going to show you is an example of what I feel is an irrational censorship. Now, when I show you this bumper sticker, I'm talking about the one on the bottom. There's a picture of two bumper stickers. But anyways, this is the bumper stickers. All right. Now, as you can see, the top bumper sticker, I have no problem with. This is someone who's a patriotic veteran of an American war who is proud to serve his country, whether he volunteered or got drafted, whatever the case may be. He is proud to have served time, I guess you do call it serving time. I didn't want to make it sound like it was like serving in prison or anything like that. He served his country by giving his voluntary or drafted time to fight a war in a foreign land that he may or may not have agreed with, but he was proud to do so. Have absolutely no problem with that whatsoever. The second bumper sticker, on the other hand, the "if you haven't been there, shut your mouth." Oh, I have a huge problem with that. I have a huge problem with that concept when it gets applied to anything. Not just an opinion of a war, but an opinion of a person, of a place, of a thing, of anything that you want to attach this fallacy to. The whole, if you haven't been there, you don't have the right to talk about it. Now, one, I would just like to point out just a little potential hypocrisy with this. Because what does this mean for people that were for the Vietnam War? Because you have to take for granted, and I'm sure many of you seen that, you'd say, oh, well, this guy doesn't like people speaking out against the Vietnam War. And there's a lot of people that do, for legit reasons, they despise the Vietnam War. And there's a lot of people that share that same opinion. So when you see that, you say, wow, this guy, you know, he doesn't like people talking out about the war that he proudly served in. Well, I would have to ask you this. What if it's someone like, you know, George W. Bush, the former president of the United States, who, you know, he hasn't necessarily shunned Vietnam. he felt that it was a just cause, even back during the time of Vietnam. You know, he thought it was a just cause and a right thing to do for the United States. How can he say that? He never served time in Vietnam. How can he say anything about the Vietnam War if he's never served time there? You see what I'm saying? Why should this only apply to people that speak out negatively against something? By that own logic, the people that haven't been there that have something positive to say, they shouldn't be allowed to say it either, right? But anyway, just seeing this bumper sticker just made me think, it's like, what's going through this person's mind? What is going through this person's mind that they want to censor anyone that has anything to say against what they do or what they did in their past? Like, I don't get that. I just don't get that. And again, yeah, okay, if someone is invading his personal space, like his house or something like that, or getting in his face every day, then he should be able to take actions to silence that person. Much like when someone comes to this channel here, and I feel they are stepping over the lines of leaving just a simple disagreement and taking it to a personal level. A level of trying to kill me, or speak out personally about me, or people in my life, stuff of that nature. If I want to silence them for making things too personal, I should have the right to do that, much like this guy should have the right to, if someone personally gets in his face and speaks a negative opinion that he doesn't want to hear, he should be able to say, you know what, not right now, not my time. If you want to go in the town center and scream at the top of your lungs how much of an asshole, go right ahead. Everyone else has any other corner of this website they want to yell at me at. If I feel you cross the line, then I have the right to just shush you, much like this guy has the right to shush you, and then you can have your parade somewhere else. So, I'm a big believer in the phrase of, and I think I said this earlier, of, you know, I might not agree with what you have to say, but I will gladly defend your right to say it. I'm a big, big advocate of free speech. Again, do I get kind of sensitive when things get a little too personal here? Absolutely. Never said I never blocked anyone here or never erased a comment. Come on! People act like that's a new concept when you see someone remove a comment or block someone. But anyway, it all kind of goes hand in hand with what this bumper sticker was, but to a degree that, like I said earlier, I feel is just completely unnecessary when anyone has the right to publicly say what they wish, much like you have the right to publicly say whatever you want on your bumper sticker. I would never tell you to remove that bumper sticker, and if someone else did to tell you that, I would call them an asshole. I would say they are just no better than anyone else that wants to censor someone's free will opinion. It's violating no one's rights. It's just stating that he's a proud serviceman, servicewoman, whatever the case may be, of a war in a foreign land. But he doesn't like people speaking out against it. I may not understand that, but by God, he has the right to do it. So, anyway, just an example of how just walking around in everyday life, you can see something that just, you know, makes you scratch your head. And, you know, I wonder, like, what would you guys think if you saw a bumper sticker like that? Like, I mean, would you just, like, not even care? Would you say something to it personally? I mean, I personally, like, wouldn't confront someone in, you know, real life. Like, even if I saw the guy in the car or whatever. I just, like I said, it just makes me wonder what's going through the person's mind to say that, you know, you can't say something unless you've been there. I mean, that's like saying, well, no one should say anything bad about slavery if you weren't a slave, or you can't say anything about a concentration camp unless you were a Jewish person that got captured and put into a concentration camp. Like, you can just go across the board with any race, creed, ethnicity, any facet, corner of their existence where their specific group was put in a difficult circumstance that people may have a negative opinion about one way or the other. So, anyways, just a perfect example, just walking around in just everyday life and just seeing something, and there you go, you got another rant video from me. So, anyways, everyone, have a great day. Crixus! Crixus! Come here, Crixus! Come here, boy! Come here, buddy! Come here, baby! Oh, never mind, Girlfiend's eating. Crixus is ignoring me. Typical dog. Oh, who wants the Eagles football? Who wants the Eagles football? Who wants the Eagles football? Go! Fucker! Go get
funny.
Your ball. Alright. You know, one thing girls don't understand is that when you get hit in the nuts, that's what you get! Crooks has stole her food! That's what she gets for laughing at me.
Meanie.
What a lot of girls don't understand is like when a guy gets hit in the nuts, it makes you feel like you want to throw up. Like, it hurts more in your stomach than anywhere else. It's weird. I don't.
Yeah, that happens every month. It's called a period.
I don't want to know that. Anyway, women. Anyway, Girlfriend's gonna finish feeding the rest of her lunch to Crixus. And Crixus is gonna eat it up good. Anyway, everyone have a fantastic day. Display your bumper stickers at your will, no matter what they say, as long as, you know, you don't give like someone's name and phone number, like an ex-lover or something that, you know, say call for a good blowjob, like something like that. Anyway, you get what I'm saying. Keep things to a non-personal level, people. Say what you gotta say, and just make sure it's not too obscene. Take care. It's trying to suck my soul out. I see it.
Four slices of American cheese. Beer. Waffle runoff.
This was probably the weirdest final 3 minutes in an Archfiend video in history. I'm sorry, people. I don't know where the hell this video went. It just, like, was going this way, and then all of a sudden went, yum! Again, have a great day, and I'm just going to just end this strange video right now.